been 18 and 60, my dear, I'm loving St. John. Your good friend, the schoolmaster, Pat McNamara's so good as to write these words down. Your brothers have all gone to find work in England, the house is so empty and sad. And the crop of potatoes solely infected, a third to a half of them bad. And your sister Bridget and Patrick O'Donnell are going to be married in June. Your mother says not to work on the railroad and be sure to come on home soon. Kilkelly, I'm 18 and 70, my dear and loving St. John. Hello to your missus, and to your four children, and may they grow healthy and strong. Michael has got in a wee bit of trouble, I suppose that he never will learn. Because of the dampness, there's no turf to speak of, now we have nothing to burn. And Bridget is happy, you named a child for her, although she's got six on her own. You see, from work, she don't say what kind of, or when you will be coming home. Kilkelly, I've 1880, dear Michael and John, my sons. Sorry to give you the very sad news that your dear old mother's gone. We buried her down at the church in Kilkelly, your brothers and Bridget were there. You don't have to worry, she died very quickly, remember her in your prayers. And it's so good to hear that Michael's returning, and the money's sure to buy land. But the crop has been poor, the people are selling at every price that they can. I've 18 and 90, my dear, and loving St. John. Suppose that I must be close on to 80, and it's 30 years since you're gone. And because of all of the money you sent me, I'm still living out my own. Built himself a fine house, and Richard's daughters have grown. And thank you for sending your family picture, a lovely young woman and man. You say that you might even come for a visit, joy to see you. Kilkelly, I've 18 and 92, my dear brother John. Sorry that I didn't write sooner to tell you that father passed on. He was living with Bridget, she said he was cheerful and healthy right down to the end. Should have seen him playing with the grandchildren of Pat McNamara, your friend. And we buried him on the long side of mother down at the Kilkelly. cut each yard. He was a strong and a feisty old man, considering the life was so hard. And it's funny the way he kept talking about you and calling for you in the end. And why don't you think about coming to visit? We'd all love to see you.